Welcome back to another episode of the Casey Campbell Podcast. Casey Campbell with you, of course, and we are pleased to be joined by Natalie Decker, of course, who is driving the number 23 part-time for our motorsports this season in the NASCAR Xfinity Series. How's it going, Natalie?
I'm doing good. Thank you for having me. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. So I know you've had a couple starts this year in Xfinity. How do you think they've been going so far?
Well, we started off at Daytona, and that was the Daytona road course, and that did not go well at all. We got rear-ended really hard going into the last like chicane on the front straightaway, and that ended our night when that happened. But after that, we went to Talladega, and that just recently happened, and the race was going so well, other than I didn't have a spotter, which not a lot of people know that. Like, I did have a spotter, but the radios weren't working, and I had like no communication with my spotter or my crew chief. So that was really terrifying because it was my first Xfinity race, like on a really big track like that. And I was really hoping that I was gonna be able to hear my spotter talk me through the whole thing. And we were just, our plan was just to hang out in the back and let the big one happen. But then the rain came and the big one never really happened because the rain ended the race short, but we finished 24th, and that was a win just because at Talladega, there's so much you can't control and so many crazy things can happen. So for the craziest thing to happen, having rain end our night early, that's a pretty good thing.
Yeah. So Natalie, I know you're running a limited amount of races this year. Where can we see you next? When's your next race?
So my next race is going to be in Nashville, and my sponsor, Red Street Records, they're based out of Nashville. So it's going to be so much fun. We're going to go early, and I'm going to get to hang out with my sponsors, do a couple things with them. And it's like their hometown race. So it's going to be pretty exciting. After that, we have Road America. And then after Road America, we have the Martinsville race, which will be our last race of the season.
Yeah. So kind of going into, you know, with the season, your sponsor, of course, you're going to Nashville. And of course, that's the home of, you know, with country music and all that, I'm sure. Have you gotten a chance to meet any of, you know, any of your sponsors' clients that they represent?
Yes. So when we did the reveal of the car and the sponsor and the team I was with, I got to meet the whole Red Street Records group. And then Jason Crabb, who was on the hood of the car for the Daytona race, he got to come and he was surprised. He didn't know he was on the hood of the car. So we got to surprise him. And we got to hang out all day. And it was so magical. It was like, that's the best way to explain it, is it was magical. And I got to hear him sing, and we got to film a bunch of video and promo stuff and do interviews together. And I love him so much. He's family now. And then Cade Thompson was on the hood of the car for Talladega, and I never got to meet him in person, but I got to FaceTime him, show him the car. And then right after the race, we FaceTimed again and we got to talk for a little bit. So hopefully when I get to go to Nashville, I get to see everyone in person.
Yeah. So of course, you know, I know you've been pretty busy with, you know, trying to get more races and sponsors and all that, but you've also been very busy on your Twitch channel. What have you been doing there?
I love Twitch. So we started Twitch in December, right at the end of December. And we did it because we were struggling finding sponsorship with COVID and everything. It was hard figuring out how we're going to go racing in this year. So we were like, you know what, let's just start streaming and just see how it goes and see if it takes off or if anyone likes it or enjoys watching us iRace. We mostly iRace, but I play Warzone on Wednesdays, and sometimes we play Among Us. Sometimes I just do just chatting and hang out with my fans, but it was so much fun. We were so addicted to it right away that now it's just part of our week. We do it all the time and we love it. And I'm glad that with how COVID happened and everything, how it pushed us to do something so out of my comfort zone. And now I just love it. So yeah, make sure if any of you are not following me on Twitch, you got to follow me on Twitch because we have some fun.
Yeah. Okay. So I know you play, I've watched some of your Warzone streams before. Well, have you ever played Call of Duty before you did that?
No, I've never played Call of Duty. I used to play 2K in high school a little bit.
Yeah.
And that's about it. So yeah, I'm very new. It would probably be like my sixth game or fifth game, maybe even that much this coming week on Wednesday. But yeah, I'm learning. I'm not good at it, but I do have fun.
Yeah. How are you at Among Us? Because I've played Among Us before and it's crazy.
I only played it a couple times with some of my fans. And then other than that, I've just played online with random people. But I feel like I'm decent at it. Unless I'm playing with my friends or Derek's playing with me, because then I cheat and I try and look over and if I see Derek's an imposter or whatever, I cheat really bad. So I'm usually pretty decent, but it's because I cheat.
True. I mean, well, I don't know. You probably shouldn't say that because Derek's in the room or something. I don't know.
Oh, he knows. He gets so mad. He said he won't play Among Us with me anymore because I keep trying to look over at his screen. So he won't play anymore with me.
That's funny. How often do you, so what's coming up this week on, you know, your Twitch channel? Could you have any other new things that you could try?
You never know. You never know if I'm going to try anything new, but we're actually streaming tonight. We're going to be doing iRacing a lot throughout the week and then Warzone Wednesday, and maybe we'll get Among Us in there because I know so many of my fans really want to play with me and I love doing that. It's so much fun and I really enjoy it. So maybe this week we can fit that in the schedule.
Well, yeah. Stay tuned, I guess.
Yeah.
But turn on your notifications and all that. And I don't know. So you know, you got to follow and you also got to, you know, turn on your notifications to make sure you get.
Yeah, you got to make sure it's on. You got to make sure the button's turned on or else you won't get notified when I go live and then you'll miss it.
Yeah. You know, besides that, and you know, how are you at iRacing? How are you getting better at that, all that fun stuff?
So the truth is, I used to hate iRacing and I never wanted to do it. And I was horrible at it. And then COVID happened and we started upgrading our computer and our monitor. And now we have a really nice Extreme Sim. And I then started during COVID really liking it because one, we weren't being able to go to the track and practice at all, or we weren't racing as much. So it was easy to get like your racing fix in. But once we upgraded all of our equipment, it became more realistic and it felt more real, but it is just a simulator. So it's not 100% realistic, but it's close. And now I'm addicted to it. I love it. It helps me out so much, especially with road racing and new tracks.
Yeah.
So I really enjoy it now. And I'm glad that I enjoy it now because now I can stream it on Twitch.
Nice. Yeah. It should be fun. Cause I've been having a lot of fun watching, you know, Twitch stuff and all that. So I know that a lot of drivers have been doing it, you know, obviously if you, Todd Gillen's doing it with his Twitch, he's playing Call of Duty with a couple other drivers, and I know some others do some streaming stuff. So yeah, Twitch is fun to get, you know, get connected with fans and all that, and maybe could lead to potential sponsors. Who knows?
So. You never know. You never, ever know.
All right. Well, Natalie Decker, thanks for spending a few minutes with us and good luck. We'll maybe talk to you again before once Nashville comes around.
Yeah. Thank you for having me.